हे गाइस, हाय, हेलो, नमस्ते, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वणक्कम एंड खम्मा घणी टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम गाइस, वेलकम टू टुडेस क्लास एंड दिस इज योर प्रोडिजी सीरीज फॉर सीबीएसई 9 एंड वी आर स्टडिंग ट्राइंगल्स. ऑलराइट, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज ट्राइंगल्स एंड इन दिस विल बी डिस्कसिंग कॉन्ग्रुएंसी ऑफ ट्राइंगल्स. राइट, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन अ स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन विद ट्राइंगल्स in the chapter lines and angles using the angle sub property of a triangle, exterior angle theorem for a triangle, right? Now this time I'll be talking about congruency and I'll be talking about two rules of congruency, SAS and ASA. All right, these two we'll be talking it in detail. Now moving ahead of this topic, so what is congruency? I'll tell you what is congruency. We'll solve some amazing questions also related to this as well. All right, so guys, this is Gopal Paliwal, your master teacher of mathematics here at Vedantu. I have done my graduation from IIT Dhanbad and I have been teaching from the past 5 years. All right, so all these are my credentials on your screen, which you can see, and this is the chapter outline which we have done with. So first we'll be studying introduction to congruence, criteria for congruence of triangle. So in that we have SAS, ASA, SSS and RHS. Okay, so we'll be talking about these two today. Okay, then some more other properties of triangle as well. All right guys, okay, so let us start with our first topic. Now by the end of this class you'll be able to solve questions like this. By the end of this session you'll be able to solve a question like this. All right, so don't worry, it's an easy question, but first let us understand what congruency means. So guys, all of us know triangle is a polygon of three sides, hai na? And it has three angles, three vertices. All of us know about triangles. Now, what is the meaning of congruency? What is the meaning of congruency? So guys, listen carefully. Dekho, congruency means exactly equal. Two shapes, if they are, or two figures, if they are exactly equal in shape and size, then it will be called congruent. All right. For example, let's say my two hands, hai na? My two hands, if I keep them on top of each other, you can see they are exactly overlapping each other. So I can say my hands are congruent. So what is the meaning of congruency, bacha? The meaning of congruency is two figures which are, all right, figures which are exactly equal in shape and size. All right, they are exactly equal in the shape as well as the size. Theek hai bacha, that is the meaning of congruency. So as an example, I have told you my hand. Now for example, let's say I'll say this is one phone I have. All right, so my phone, this phone will be congruent to this phone of the same company, same brand, hai na? It will be exactly congruent. But if I compare it with some other phone, then I'll say they are not congruent because they are not overlapping each other. So from here, one more thing you can understand, guys, that congruent shapes overlap each other. Okay? Congruent shapes overlap each other. They can overlap each other. Now it does not mean that if I will say I have told you my hands are congruent, I will put them on each other like this and I will say they are not overlapping, so they are not congruent. This is not the way. Alright, what is allowed? You can turn the shape, you can twist, you can tilt the shape, hai na? You can change its rotation, that all you can do. You can rotate the shape, you can turn the shape, that all is allowed, and by doing that you can place them exactly on top of each other. So that is called congruency. So simple thing, exactly equal in shape as well as size. Okay? So that's for the objects which we see nearby, if they are exactly equal. Carbon copy of each other. We say, no, ekdum carbon copy. So if they are like copy of each other, we'll say they are congruent. Alright? Now in polygons, if we talk about the congruency of polygons, we want them to be exactly equal. So we want same number of sides in both, hai na? Same number of sides should be there. Corresponding sides should be of same length. By this side must be equal. This side and this side must be equal. All the corresponding sides must be equal. Then only they'll be able to overlap each other. All the corresponding interior angles must be equal. है ना, तो टू मेक देम एग्जैक्टली इक्वल टू ईच अदर, आई हैव टोल्ड नंबर ऑफ साइड्स मस्ट बी सेम, लेंथ ऑफ साइड्स मस्ट बी सेम एंड इंटीरियर एंगल्स मस्ट बी सेम, सो दे विल बी एग्जैक्टली सेम. तो सेम रूल विल फॉलो फॉर ट्राइंगल्स ऑल्सो. आई विल से इफ टू ट्राइंगल्स विल बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट, इफ लिसन वेरी केयरफुली, टू ट्राइंगल्स विल कॉल्ड विल सेट टू बी कॉन्ग्रुएंट इफ ऑल देयर करेस्पॉन्डिंग साइड्स आर ऑफ इक्वल लेंथ. दैट मीन्स लेट से कि भाई दिस साइड एंड दिस साइड इज इक्वल, दिस साइड एंड दिस साइड इज इक्वल एंड दिस साइड एंड दिस साइड इज इक्वल. All the corresponding sides are equal and all the corresponding angles are equal. Angle A and angle P, let's make it equal. Angle B and angle Q, let's make it equal. And angle C and angle R, let's make it equal. All right, so if I have two triangles like this, in which all the three sides, corresponding side, देखो, AC, PR, AB, PQ, BC, QR, and the corresponding angles are equal, then we'll say triangles are said to be congruent, and this is your sign of congruency. This is your sign of congruency, ठीक है? So we want six things to be equal. All the three corresponding sides must be equal. All the three corresponding angles must be equal. If that is true, the triangles will be congruent. ठीक है? तो बेटा, this congruency is required. कि भाई, if we do the construction of when we do the units, we want the products to be exactly same, है ना? How do we make exactly same products? What is the geometry behind that? To study all that, congruency is very important. ठीक है बच्चा? Now please join the Vedantus 9th and 10th channels, English channel Telegram group. If you are missing on any update or any schedule, because on this group, you'll be getting the regular schedules, updates, everything you'll be getting over here. ठीक है? अब देखो बेटा, when I talk about congruency of triangles, I have told you ना, कि suppose if AC and PR is equal, AB and PQ is equal, BC and QR is equal, let's say this angle A and angle P is equal, this angle C and this angle R is equal, this angle B and this angle Q is equal. If this is what is told to you, then I can say they will be congruent. है ना? तो बेटा, remember, when I write the triangles, I will write triangle ABC is congruent with triangle. अब देखो, writing the name is also very important. You will see over here that A and P are the corresponding points. B and Q are the corresponding points. C and R are the corresponding points. So triangle P, Q, R. This is how you need to write. You cannot write it in any order. It's not like you can write it in any order you want. No. You have to see whether the corresponding points are matching or not. If I keep this triangle on top of each other, A and P will match. B and Q will match, C and R will be matching, है ना? AB and PQ will match, तो देखो, AB and PQ will match, BC and QR will be matching, so select the next two words, BC and QR will be matching, and AC, first and third, AC and PR will be matching. So this is how you get to know that what are the corresponding sides, what are the corresponding angles, and writing the name is very important. It's not like you can write it in any order you want, ठीक है? Okay, one more thing beta, that dekho, once we got to know, suppose if I give you that the triangles are congruent, you can say all the corresponding angles will be equal and all the corresponding sides will be equal. So that we in the short form write CPCT. If I have to write something is equal because the triangles are congruent, I write CPCT, whose full form is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Since they are corresponding parts of the congruent triangles, they will be equal. This is the reason we write. Okay, now every time we'll not be looking checking all the six things, hai na? By all the six things, no need to check every time, and that much information also is not available most of the times. So there are some rules with which if we check only three things also, if those rules are satisfied, then we can say all the six things are going to be equal, or we can say triangles will be congruent. So we first start with angle, side, angle, and guys, please remember the name of the rule is very important. What is the name of the rule? Angle, side, angle. So you can clearly see here we have side in between and angles are on the side. Angles are on the extremes, side is in the middle. What does it mean? That suppose if you have a triangle, suppose let's say it is a triangle ABC and this is a triangle PQR. You can call it congruent if dekho, one side is equal in both the triangles, and on that side the angle given over here is, let's say, angle A and here angle P, they are equal, and here angle C and angle R, they are equal. So you can see the order, dekho yahan pe, angle, side, angle rule. All right, here also angle, side, angle rule. All right, that is why I have told you name is very important. So one side and two angles present on the side. ASA rule is what? One side and two angles present on the side will be equal to one side and two angles present on the angles present on that side of the other triangle. If that is true, we can say that the triangles are congruent. And once I got to know that the triangles are congruent, now I can clearly say, sir, AB and PQ will be equal, BC and QR will be equal, angle B and angle Q will be equal by CVCT. Because once I know they are congruent, I can say, yes, sir, the remaining parts are also going to be equal. Okay? That is ASA. Remember, two angles, sides in the between. Now, from this rule, you get one more rule. This is your rule number one. There is one more rule which is very much related to it. That is your AAS rule. Ab dekho, again, remember the order AAS. So, what does this order mean? Two angles and then the side. Two angles and then the side. So, for example, let's say, beta, I gave you this angle and this angle is equal. Alright. Then I gave you this angle and this angle is equal. Alright. Let's say it is ABC. Let's say it is PQR. Ab dekho, beta, if I give you AB and PQ equal, then it will be angle side angle, angle side angle, hai na? But instead of giving you AB and PQ equal, if I give you BC and QR equal, BC and QR equal, so that will be proved congruent. Ab dekho, if we go with the geometry, na, I know if angle A and angle P are equal, angle B and angle Q are equal, hai na? So angle C will be what? 180 minus angle A minus angle B. And angle R will be 180 minus angle P minus angle Q. And if angle A and angle P, angle B and angle Q are equal, angle C and angle R also is going to be equal only. Hai na? If you want, dekho, make this 40, make this 70. 40 plus 70 is 110. Angle C you will be getting a 70 degree. Make here again, this is 40, this is 70. Again here also, you will be getting 70 degree. So, if two angles of a triangle are equal to two angles of another triangle, third angle automatically becomes equal. So every time writing all that is why we have made a shortcut, the angle side rule also will work. So two angles and the side. Two angles and the side. So no need to write and prove ki now angle C and angle R will be equal and then applying ASA. You can directly apply angle side rule as well. So two rules I have taught you till now. First is angle side angle and then angle side. Remember, the order is very important. Two angles and the side containing them and then two angles and the side adjacent to them. Hai na? Two angles side adjacent to them. Two angles side adjacent to them. So then I can say they also will be called congruent. Okay? So two rules. Now let's solve some questions. But before that, guys, very important news and an amazing news that Vedantu has got 100 plus selections in NTSC stage 2 and that too from different parts of our country. So congratulations to all those students, and yes, you can also be an NTSC scholar. Just join Vedantu subscription courses and there we are doing the crash courses for NTSC as well. Okay guys, now look at this question. Let's solve this question. What this says, in the given figure, BE and CF are two equal altitudes of triangle ABC. Show that triangle ABE is congruent to triangle ACF. Okay, so dekho, if you want, you can draw these triangles separately. If you want, you can draw these triangles separately. Theek hai? Toh, at the starting, if you want, I will show you by drawing it separately. Let's say this is your triangle AEB and let's say it is your triangle AFC. I'm trying to draw it in a way where they look kind of same. A, E, B, and A, F, C. Now, beta, dekho. Oh, E is 90 degree over here, na? Chalo, 90 degree. That is 90 degree. Also, they have given BF is equal to CF. Sorry, BE is equal to CF. It is also given. Ab beta dekho, in this, either you talk about triangle ABE, we are talking about this angle A, or you talk about triangles AFC, again we are talking about angle A. So, I can clearly say, sir, angle A is also common over here. So, which rule we are following? Dekho, first thing I can say, angle A is equal to angle A because it is common. One angle I got common. After that, angle AEB is equal to angle AFC because both are equal to 90 degrees. Two angles, and then the next side, BE is equal to CF, it is given equal. So, which rule it is? Angle, angle, side. So, I can clearly say, sir, by AAS rule, angle, angle, side rule, triangle AEB is congruent to triangle AFC. Or, if I interchange B and E, I will see C and F. So, ABE, ACF. Okay? Done? We have got the congruency. First part done. Show that AB is equal to AC. Guys, by CPCT, I can clearly say, by CPCT, AB and AC also will be equal because they are corresponding parts of the congruent triangles. Okay? Dekho, this is how this question will be done. Alright, next question. In the given figure, AB is parallel to CD, O is the midpoint of AD. Show that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Theek hai? Chalo, first one let's solve. In triangle AOB and triangle DOC. Now, before writing, na, look at both the figures and what are the things you know. Okay. This question can be solved with angle angle side also. Or angle side angle also. Okay, I'll do it with ASA this time. So, dekho beta, since I know these two lines are parallel, I can say, sir, this angle and this angle A will be equal. Interior alternate. Then I know O is the midpoint of AD. That means AO and OD is given. And then I can say, sir, here O is vertically opposite angles. So, in both the triangle, dekho, angle side angle, here also angle side angle. Alright, theek hai. So, beta, I can say, dekho, first thing I will write, that sir, angle ODC is equal to, or angle OA, first I will write AOB wala. Angle OAB is equal to angle ODC because both are interior alternate angles. Then I can say, sir, AO is equal to OD because O is midpoint of AD. And then the last thing I can say, that sir, angle AOB is equal to angle DOC because they are vertically opposite angles. So, write in the order also, dekho, angle, side, angle. So, now I can say, sir, by angle, side, angle rule, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Okay? First one done. A and D are the corresponding point, O is the corresponding point, C and D will be the corresponding point. Now, if they are congruent, I can clearly say, sir, by CPCT, I can clearly say BO and OC will also be equal. BO is equal to OC, and if BO is equal to OC, from here we can clearly say O is midpoint of BC. Theek hai? O is midpoint of BC. This is how this question will be done. Easy, easy peasy. Okay, guys. Theek hai? Now, let's go for one more question. One more question karte hain. This again, dekho, is very easy. Just look at the diagram, you'll get your answer. In the given figure, AD and BC are equal perpendicular. So, we got to know AD and BC are equal. Guys, these information, na, it is, I'll give you a trick right now for geometry. Whenever diagram is given, and whatever information is given in the question, try to represent them in the diagram. For example, I know AD and BC are equal perpendicular, so I have dropped this line to make me remember that AD and BC are equal. ठीक है, to the line segment AB, show that CD bisect AB. That means CD and AB are bisecting each other. है ना? Or we have to prove O is the midpoint of both. ठीक है, तो देखो बेटा, first thing I got to know कि सर देखो, one side is equal, one angle is equal. है ना? One side is equal and one angle is equal. And one more thing is over here, if two lines are intersecting, the vertically opposite angles formed also are going to be equal. So again, by angle, angle, side, both will be congruent. So I can say, sir, in triangle OAD and triangle OBC, first thing, sir, angle AOD is equal to angle BOC because they are vertically opposite angles. Then I can say, sir, angle A and angle B are equal because both are equal to 90 degrees. And then it is given to us that AD is equal to BC. It is given. So it is angle-angle side rule. So I can clearly say, sir, by AAS rule, triangle OAD is congruent to triangle OBC. And if they are congruent to each other, beta, I can clearly say by CPCT that OA and OB is equal and OD and OC is equal. So I can say OA is equal to OB and I can say OD is equal to OC by CPCT. And then from these two results, we can clearly say AD and CD bisect each other. Right, both of them are dividing each other in two equal parts. All right, so this is how this question will be done. So guys, if you will start understanding the question and focus on the diagram, if you will start focusing on the diagram, you will definitely get the questions. Questions are not that difficult. Okay, what it says over here, in the given figure, line L is the bisector of an angle A and B is any point on L. ठीक है, so this A is here, this L is the bisector. So bisector means these two are going to be equal. है ना? B is any point on this line L. BP and BQ are perpendiculars from B to the arms of angle A. So BP is perpendicular, BQ is also perpendicular. चलो, very well done. They are saying show that APB is congruent to AQB and BP is equal to BQ. So once we got to know the congruency by CPCT, we can say that. Now let's look at the congruency of these two. ठीक है, तो I can say, sorry, in triangle APB and triangle AQB. By first thing, बच्चों, 90 degrees there in both. Angle P is equal to angle Q, both are 90 degree. Second thing, angle PAB is equal to angle QAB. Why? Because L is angle bisector. By that line is angle bisector na? Hai na? So two angles, and then bacha, I know AB is the common side. AB is the common side for both the triangles. So it must be equal. So angle side rule. So I can again say, sir, by angle side rule, triangle APB is congruent to triangle AQB. And if they are congruent, I can clearly say by CPCT that sir, BP is equal to BQ. It's all about focusing on the diagram, guys. You have seen me every time. I'll see the diagram carefully. I'll note all the information given in the question on the diagram. And then I'll think, what are the three things? How can I get them congruent? That's what you have to do in throughout this session. Hai na? And if you're liking this trick, guys, trust me on this. Vedantus Pro subscription is going to be much more beneficial because there you have a more personalized way of learning. All right. And also, it comes with the guarantee of Vedantus, of your improvement. Hai na? And that's the guaranteed improvement, and we call it Vedantus Improvement Promise. That is VIP. So, since it is a guaranteed improvement, beta, in this, if you do not see any improvement in your performance, by the end of the year, you will be returned your whole fees. We'll return your whole fee to you, no question asked. That's the guarantee we are giving you. Only thing we want, that once you take our pro course, you need to attend minimum 75% of the classes and 75% of the test, which is like very less, you know? And that is only kept so that if suppose students sometimes have real urgent issues or real personal issues with which, because of which they cannot attend the class. So for that reason, 25% of the classes in a year, no problem. Ki haan, okay. But more than that, if you are missing, that means you are not even regular. So if you are not regular, no one can buy education, right? You have to do your hard work as well. But in this guarantee, we are also with you. We are saying, beta, you work hard, you come to our class, we'll make sure you'll improve. Hai na? So that's the only thing. You just come to the class, we'll make sure you'll improve. Alright guys, so there are unlimited live classes. Now what are the features? So features are unlimited live classes. Students from different parts of the world, you will be able to interact with them, learn from them, and they'll also be able to learn from you. Make a great community. Alright, interactive replays, that means even while watching the recording of a class, you'll be able to attend the quizzes, see your name in the leaderboard, and get the marks for it. So revision also is going to be now, what do I say? Interesting, because you'll be able to attend the quizzes. Then you'll get notes, test, assignments, everything at one place. No need to go to thousands of places. Also, you'll be getting in-class doubt solving. What does it mean? That in each and every class, other than the master teacher, there will be extra teachers present in the class whom we call class teachers. So class teachers will be connected with you throughout the class. You can talk to them anytime in the class and they will be taking care of each and every doubt. So your doubt does not have to wait till the end of the class or something. All your doubts will be solved at that moment only. Alright guys, and then there are unlimited micro courses and crash courses to choose from. So you can choose any of these courses, and the benefit which you will be getting from these courses is you can attend as many classes as you want, hai na? You can revise a topic as many times as you want. You can study a topic as many times as you want. And also, with the help of micro courses, you can attend the classes of different teachers, meet them and learn from them. Suppose, ki yaar, sir, let's see how sir is teaching this topic and interact with them, all your favorite teachers. Okay, guys, so all these features you are getting at a very less price. Remember, less is more, less price, more classes. So that's our motto. The link for registration to this Vedantus Pro subscription is mentioned in the description box of this video as well as in the pinned comment. You just have to go there, but the main thing to help you out over there is this code GPE Pro, which will get you instant 10% off. Instant 10% off you are going to get with GPE Pro. Alright, and this will reduce the price. So let me show you how you can do that. Suppose this is a video. Alright, now in the pinned comment, you can see over here, subscribe to Vedantu Pro now, click on this link, or in the description box, subscribe to Vedantu courses now, click on this link. Once you have clicked over here, beta, here you have to choose your grade. I have chosen grade 9. Now here you can choose any course, CBSE, ICSE, Maharashtra board, you want to go for foundation courses, anything. I am choosing CBSE 9th. Alright, now you have here three types of courses: Pro Lite, Pro Classic, Pro Plus. Dekho, in Pro Lite, GPE Pro we have already applied, so the price has been reduced by 10%. Here also in Pro Classic, if I'll apply GPE Pro, dekho, GPE Pro applied, it changed from 41 to 37,300. And this will change from 53 to 48,599 by applying GPE Pro. Now you'll see, sir, you'll ask, sir, what is the difference between the three courses? So guys, dekho, first thing, these three courses, let me tell you one thing very clearly. The classes are going to be exactly same in all the three courses. There is no difference in that. Classes will be exactly same. Alright. The only difference is what happens after the class. Alright. So in Pro Lite, you get all the features which I have told you till now. Live classes, test series, assignments, notes, doubt solving in the class using class teachers. Alright, so that's our most basic course, and this course is for, like, would be most suitable for those students who are good with the studies but they want more conceptual clarity. They are like, sir, I am able to solve the questions rightly, I am able to get the answers, but I want concepts to be explained to me in more detail and in clarity. So for them, ProLite will be a very good course. Now for those students who feel that, sir, after the class, I understand everything in the class, I really like studying in the class, but after the class when I start solving the questions, I get doubts, sir. And those doubts I'm not able to solve the questions, and when I get so many doubts, I start feeling demotivated. And it's not a bad thing, it's happened to the best of us. And for those students, Pro Classic is the course, guys, because other than all the basic features, there is also one more extra feature, that is unlimited doubt solving on mobile app. So in the Vedantus Doubts app, you can ask as many questions as you want, no restriction at all. So whenever you are solving questions after the class, you got a doubt, take the photo of the doubt, post it in the Doubts app, and your doubts will be resolved. So now you will no longer feel demotivated, because you know that if you are getting a doubt, you will be able to get a solution for it. Okay? And then comes Pro Plus. So Pro Plus is for those students, guys, suppose if you want more personal support, if you want someone, you want more personal attention, you want someone to take care of your studies, someone to motivate you in between, someone who will take your doubts classes also separately. So you feel motivated, you think your subjects, you find subjects challenging, so they give more personal attention to you. Your Pro Plus is the course for you, because it has one more extra feature, that is personal mentor. So they'll be act as a rigid support system, and they'll make sure that all your doubts, academic, non-academic, are resolved. Alright guys, now you can try any of these course for 1 month if you want. And if you are already familiar with Vedantu, directly you can buy a complete course, and that will give you Vedantu's guaranteed improvement also. Again, please don't forget that here GPE Pro you need to apply so that you get 10% off. Alright guys, and any other information which I was supposed not able to explain to you, all your doubts will be answered at the bottom of this page in this frequently asked questions. So you can go through these questions as well for more inquiry. Alright, now let me show you the features. Let me show you the features, how it looks. For example, if you want to see the notes, click here on get notes, and you'll be able to see how your notes will look like. Dekho, in the teacher's handwriting. So you can be pretty sure that everything is going to be amazing. Alright, everything is going to be correct. Next thing is replay. If you want to watch a recording of the class or replay of the class, you can watch on replay. And if you want to attend the quiz also, click on try alternate replay. So once you click on try alternate replay, now you have entered into the classroom setup. Here you'll be seeing me, and here you'll be getting the quizzes options, everything. Alright? Theek hai bachcho, so these are the the features of the Pro subscription courses, and a very good course, and it will definitely help you in the improvement of your marks. And now there's a guarantee for it. It's not just saying things in the air, it's a guarantee. Alright guys, chalo, let's go for the next criteria. So we have learned two criteria till now, ASA and AAS. Okay, name is very important. Angle side angle or angle angle side. Now the third criteria which we are studying is side angle side. So now understand the name over here one more time, side angle side. What does it mean? Two sides and the angle between them. What does it mean? Two sides and the angle between them. Suppose in these two triangles, if I tell you this side and this side is equal to each other, this side and this side is equal to each other, and this angle is equal to each other. Then I can say, dekho sir, two sides and the angle between them. If this is the case, we can say both the triangles will be congruent. Okay? That is your side angle side rule. Guys, remember, it is side angle side. You cannot say angle side side or side side angle. That does not work. These are not rules. Two sides and the angle between them. Two sides and the angle between them. It is the rule. Okay? So side, angle, side. Alright guys, chalo, let's look at a question. In quadrilateral ABCD, AC is equal to BD, and AB bisects angle A. So angle A is divided into equal parts. Show that triangle ABC is similar to triangle ABD. Sorry, congruent to triangle ABD. How easy it is, yaar. ABC and ABD mein, first thing I can say, sir, in triangle ABC and triangle ABD, first thing AC is equal to AD given to me. Then I can say, sir, angle CAB is equal to angle DAB because AB is the bisector and AB is the common side. So which rule it is? By side angle side rule, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ABD, right? ठीक है, साइड एंगल साइड रूल, साइड एंगल साइड रूल. व्हाट कैन यू से बी सी एंड बी डी? सर वी कैन से बी सी एंड बी डी विल ऑल्सो बी इक्वल. बी सी एंड बी डी विल ऑल्सो बी इक्वल बाय सी पी सी टी करेस्पॉन्डिंग पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्राइंगल्स. ओके बच्चा, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ए बी सी डी इज अ क्वाड्रिलैटरल इन विच ए डी इज इक्वल टू बी सी, एंगल डी ए बी इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी बी ए. Prove all this. ठीक है, अब देखो बेटा, if you are feeling difficult to understand the triangles, you can do what? You can draw the separate diagrams for both the triangles. So let's draw separate diagrams for both the triangles. Angle, this is triangle DAB, and similarly triangle CB. DAB. And here it is C, B, A. All right. We know AD and BC is equal. Angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. These two are also equal to each other. All right. They are saying prove that these two triangles are congruent. So first one, beta, I can say, sir, in triangle ABD and triangle BAC. First thing. Guys, I can say AD is equal to BC given. Then I can say, sir, angle DAB is equal to angle CBA. It is also given. Next thing, AB is the common side. AB is equal to AB because it is the common side. So, which rule it is? By side angle side rule, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle BAC. Now, if they are congruent, second one we can easily prove by CPCT. We can write BD is equal to AC by CPCT. Yes or no? BD is equal to AC by CPCT, and angle ABD, ABD and BAC will be again equal. Third also, angle ABD is equal to angle BAC by CPCT. All right, ठीक है, done. CPCT, okay? ठीक है बच्चों, this is how this question will be done. अच्छा, one more thing guys, when you will be joining pro courses, you can also join my micro courses which are going on there. All right, and I'll be getting more and more micro courses every month, so you can join those micro courses. Okay, चलो, let's go for the next question. What this question? This is our star question now. Okay, what it says? In the given figure, O is a point in the interior of square ABCD such that OAB is an equilateral triangle. Okay. So, dekho, first thing, beta, I got to know ABCD is a square. If ABCD is a square, all sides will be equal. So, I can say AB, BC, CD, AD, all are equal to each other, right? Then it is given triangle OAB is equilateral triangle. If it is an equilateral triangle, AB, OB, OA also will be equal. So from here, you can say, sir, from these two, AB is equal to BC, is equal to CD, is equal to AD, is equal to OA, is equal to OB. All of them are equal to each other. ठीक है? They are saying, show that OCD is an isosceles triangle. If I have to prove OCD is an isosceles triangle, in a way, I have to prove these two sides equal. OD and OC. That is my focus. So what I did, beta, I saw, sir, what if I take these two triangles. I think it looks congruent. Sometimes we have to go with the feelings as well. Our feelings. Our feeling is, ki, sir, it looks congruent. Let's try proving congruency of these two triangles. proving congruency of these two triangles. All right, so if I talk about congruency of these two triangles, so what do we know over here? What do we know, bacha? Dekho yaar, in triangle OAB, in triangle OAB and triangle OAD and triangle OBC. देखो भाई, first thing I know, OA is equal to OB. That is good sign for us. Then we also know that AD is equal to BC. If I could get these two angles equal, my work will be done. ठीक है. Now how do I get these two angles equal? Listen very carefully, yeah. Listen very carefully. देखो, first thing I can say is that this angle, complete angle is 90 degree. Square है. Same way, this complete angle is also 90 degree, it is a square. Alright, so I can say, sir, angle DAB is equal to angle CBA, both will be 90 degrees. Theek hai? Alright, then I'll say, ki, sir, these angles are going to be 60 degrees and 60 degrees because this is an equilateral triangle. So in an equilateral triangle, all three angles are 60 degrees. So I can say, sir, angle OAB is equal to angle OBA, both will be equal to 60 degrees. So obviously, beta, I can say, sir, my remaining angles, which is over here, this angle will be 90 minus 60, which means 30 degree. And this is also going to be 30 degree. So I can say, sir, my angle OAD will be equal to 90 minus 60, which is 30 degree, and my angle OBC also will be 90 minus 60, which is equal to 30 degree. So here I can say, sir, angle OAD is equal to angle OBC, both will be equal to 30 degrees. So now I have got my rule, side angle side, so I can clearly say, sir, by side angle side rule, triangle OAD is congruent to triangle OBC. And once these two are congruent, beta, once we have proved these two are congruent by CPCT, I can say OD is equal to OC. Yes or no? I can say OD is equal to OC. And if OD is equal to OC, I can say triangle ODC is isosceles triangle. Done? Alright? So, when the information, bhai dekho, I saw two sides are there and I want them to prove congruent, so I want the middle angle, the angle between them to be equal. Then I used my brain, I thought, how can I get those angle equals? I saw angle A and angle B in the square are 90. And in triangle AOB, they are 60. So remaining is 30-30. They are equal. Done. Alright. This is how this question will be done. Alright, guys. So these are all the amazing questions which are there from the topic 1. We have covered 3 criteria actually. SAS. Then we have talked about AAS. And we have talked about ASA. Theek hai? These 3 criteria we have done. The next 2 criteria we'll be talking about SSS and RHS criteria. And the third session also is very important, properties of triangle. All right. Theek hai, bachho? This is your homework question. Theek hai? The L and M are 2 parallel lines intersected by another pair of lines P and Q. Show that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CD. I just want you to write in the comment section. How you are getting. No need to explain me too much in minimum words, like the rule, or you can say, sir, this is equal to this, this is equal to this, this is equal to this. Theek hai? This you, I want all of you to let me know in the comment section. Alright, bacho. So thank you so much. And the link for registration to the Vedantu Pro subscription is mentioned in the description box. Important is GPE Pro. It will save you 10% of the course fee and it will make you save your money. And guys, remember, yaar, it comes with guarantee of your improvement as well. So what else do you need, right? Okay, bacho. So batches are starting very soon. Please do not wait ki when the batch will start. That time only I'll join the course. Dekho, time does not wait for anyone. Take the course now so that in between you can start your preparation with the micro courses. Alright guys, so this is all in today's class. Thank you so much for joining the session. I hope all of you enjoyed the session. Please don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Sayonara. Khuda hafiz to all of you. Bye-bye guys.